The question, how can I give beauty to the poem I write? Study and practice. There are plenty of books on writing poetry, and plenty of good anthologies. For a book specifically on the subject of meter, I would recommend The Ode Less Travelled by Stephen Fry. It's very readable, and there are exercises at the end of each chapter. There are some shortcomings in his comprehension of meter, and this answer fills in the gaps. Kier Fabian's answer to what is a good way to check iambic pentameter? It's worth making the effort to get a handle on meter, because it gives you an ear for rhythm, and this will stand you in good stead even when you choose not to consciously adhere to any specific meter. I can give you a simple example of techniques I employ when writing a message in my daughter's birthday card, to Leona, my delightful and infuriating daughter, in the blossom of her 16th summer. So, there are broadly two aspects to look at here, the soundscape and the content. Let's look at the soundscape first. Did you notice how these lines undulate? Every other syllable is stressed. This is the iambic rhythm, though, in this case, opening on a stress. I made a conscious choice to stick to this interlacing rhythm. Another consistency is that every phrasal unit ends on an unstressed syllable. Then there's the phonetic patterning. The L and N in my daughter's name are echoed in the words delightful and infuriating. And then daughter alliterates with delightful. And at the very end we have the alliteration of 16th summer. And we have the assonance of my delightful, infuriating, in 16th, daughter, her, summer. In terms of the content, the techniques I employed were contrast and association. There's the contrast of delightful and infuriating, which is a very accurate summary of my emotional relationship with her. And then there's the association created by the word blossom, summer, of course, being the link that enables this association. This is metaphor, and it's usually far more effective and subtle than simile. Simile is when you say something is like something else, so if I'd written who's grown to be as lovely as a flower, that would have been a simile. And it's a bit obvious. Ultimately, there is no substitute for study and practice. Prosody is a craft, and like any craft, you have to work at it. I'm also going to recommend a blog, poem, shape. This belongs to a man called Patrick Gillespie, who is himself a very accomplished poet, despite the fact he is unpublished. The blog itself has plenty of really interesting posts, and Patrick is usually quite generous with his time, and may well be prepared to take a look at an example of your work and make some helpful suggestions.